and it's working for me.
Rocksteady. Hi there, and welcome to this Rocksteady After Midnight special. Well, tonight we join Mark Knopfler and his little bit on the side, the Notting Hillbillies, the band he formed as the antidote to that corporate monster, Dire Straits. The informal grouping of Brendan Croker, Guy Fletcher, Steve Phillips, and Mark himself have gone back to their musical roots for the good time sounds of early rock and roll, blues, gospel, jazz, boogie, and country and western. We sent our chart editor and respected journalist from Q magazine, Phil Sutcliffe, along to catch up with them all and have a chat about the new band and find out from Mark what was in his mind when he decided to form the Hillbillies.
12 years ago, Dire Straits' first hit, Sultans of Swing, made Mark Knopfler an overnight success at the age of 28. A gritty guitar band ploughing their own furrow through the eras of disco and punk, they just grew and grew through the 80s. Then their sixth album, Brothers in Arms, which included the single Money for Nothing, made them temporary claimants to the dubious title of biggest band in the world.
That's the way you do it. You play the guitar on MTV.
They still look the part at the Nelson Mandela 70th birthday party, performing for a global TV audience in the summer of 88. But that was a one-off. On the Brothers in Arms tour from 85 to 86, Dire Straits had played 248 concerts in 12 months. When Knopfler got back home, he was worn out and grieved to find himself feeling cut off from the roots of the music he loved. So he turned to two old friends from his early days learning country blues in Leeds, Brendan Croker and Steve Phillips.
Went ahead of my money, used to follow me around. Now I have got broke, you gotta run me down. With a rooster and crow, them old hens look around. Said if you want to make love, you gotta run me down.
Gradually, over the last 4 years, the welcome night out with his mates has evolved into the Notting Hillbillies, the band, the album, and the tour. As they cram in 40 British gigs in 42 days, the Hillbillies' on-the-road lifestyle may not be quite what Knopfler and keyboard player Guy Fletcher came to expect with Dire Straits. But the Knopfler level of perfectionism remains the same. They are rehearsing for the tour 7 days a week for 6 weeks.
Mark said, are you doing any gigs in the near future? And I said, yeah, well, I've got a couple on this particular weekend. That was within a few months of you finishing the tour, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And he came up and did a gig with me and Brendan in Leeds, in a little place, a little pub in Leeds where we were playing, Saturday night, I think it was. Mm. And I think you had a stinking good time, really, didn't you?
Yeah.
That's one way of putting it.
This was the Hillbillies' debut, was it?
I suppose in a way it was. I think it's probably the first time I think of that the three of us actually played in public together. It seemed to me like the continuation of something that had been going on for years. It never seemed, didn't seem strange at all at the time.
I believe you were in Leeds for about 5 years, weren't you, Mark, as a cub reporter and then as a student at the university?
I was in a couple of, on a newspaper and three at the university. And the day that I graduated, I went to London and joined a professional rock and roll band.
So through all that 10, 12, 15 years after you left Leeds, Mark, you managed to stay in touch?
Mm.
How did you do that?
Semaphore, wasn't it?
Well, I think my mates are very, by and large, been very forgiving. You know, as far as you get away for long periods of time, I mean, you shake your hand and say, how's it all going? You know, I just sort of pick up a guitar and carry on where you left off, really, and there may be a couple of new chords to pass around. But that's really it.
In that land across the sea, there's a job for you and me. Though our presence there may not be found, we must stay standing there on the battle lines and pray. We must never lay our weapons down. We don't have to be a soldier in a uniform to be of service over there. While the boys so bravely stand with the weapons made by hand, let us trust and use the weapon of praise. Thousand miles away, someone shed their blood today. With a heart so true and brave, they're gone to a war that's yours and mine. Let us join the battle line with a weapon that will save our home. We don't have to be a soldier to be of service over there. While the boys so bravely stand with the weapons made by hand, let us trust and use the weapon of praise.
Guy, not being a member of the Leeds Mafia, how did you find yourself slotting into this setup of the Hillbillies?
They came down to the news one day. There they were. They sat down. They played their guitars, and I just sat in front of the keyboard and the machine, and just started working out and thinking about drum tracks and patterns and things. And I would just get on in my own little way in interpreting their tunes, and I'd offer suggestions, and that's how we started. Really, it was all. It was all very loose.
Have you developed a particular favourite amongst them all?
Well, Bewildered was my favourite for a long time, because I particularly like the way we did that.
Why must I have sleepless nights and endless days? But love, you left my soul.
Bewildered, that's Lonnie Johnson, isn't it?
Lonnie Johnson is a seriously underrated figure because he actually influenced B.B. King and people like that, who then influenced shoals of other players.
Are you guys queuing up to be accused of being purists here? Is there some hazard of that?
No danger of that. They're purists are going to hate it. I think it's just something based on a love affair with music. I do think, that, though, that a lot of these songs have got a lot of depth and a lot of beauty, and they should be heard by more people.
Right, so you're a fairly unusual band, and I gather you're going out on a fairly unusual tour about to start it. Guy, it's not quite in the manner to which you're accustomed with Dire Straits, I think, is it?
No, but it's certainly going to be enjoyable. I'm looking forward to the rehearsals, actually, because we don't really quite know what's going to happen.
So you'll be carrying your own amps, of course.
Well, judging from the state of my personal roadie at the moment, yes, we will be.
1, 2, 3...
Your song on the album is Your Own Sweet Way. keep the company comfortably?
Well, by that time the album had got so far away from a strict sort of hillbilly style of a record, really, that it didn't matter. I mean, so slotted right in.
Sweet stuff. Hope you enjoyed that. Ed Bicknell on drums, Marcus Cliff on bass, and of course Brendan Croker, Steve Phillips, Guy Fletcher, and some other bloke on the guitar. By the way, that song the Hillbillies were rehearsing for the UK tour is a new Knopfler composition. It's called When It Comes to You, and could well make it onto a new Dire Straits album. Remember where you heard it first.